Right. Is this life? Looks like it is. Okay. Straight off the bat, we are live with the Cybergamer Summer League Grand Finals. And the scope from Arcane just tagged up Macha. Macha does manage to get himself across, which is a good thing. Now he has spotted one at the half track area. And we can definitely see now that Arcane knows there's going to be one across. They are pretty reluctant to go towards that B bomb center. Icon's actually going to grenade down already on Izuka, so looks to be like an epic round there as Hat comes around with the shotgun, shuts down Savvy, and it's looking good here. Epic, they got a pretty solid line of defense, and I doubt Arcane are going to be able to find any sort of peek here. Danae's been shut down by Anaxakar. How did Danae actually get across there without being seen? So, Jordan and Hatton, both the British guys, up against the full lineup of Dutchies. Icons does go down, but it's going to be Hatton here in the mid garden that has just revealed this position. Oh, actually going to down Viagor as well, and this could be problematic here for FX, but looks like Hat is going to be sitting in deep over at A. Macha already pushed up, and if Jordan can find him, actually he does spot Macha out there, should be able to get that frag in. And there we go, Jordan is going to rush out. Time is of the essence now, he's going to have to go towards that bomb site, get that bomb down. And Alexakar is rotating his way down there, knowingly that Jordan, he can't go towards that A side, has just to hear the confirmation there. And Anaxagar should be just going in, and it was actually a fake, and that is such a nice read there from Anaxagar. And Hat is going to be providing covering fire, and actually Anakin will take him out. 1-0 then, FX could have taken the lead, and it really was all the difference here that Macha got himself across towards that B bomb side. Let's see. Is it Savvy actually scoping? Okay. I thought Danny was more of the scope himself, but either way, looks like Arcane do manage to get himself onto us that B bomb side. It's on his guard to take one down. Hatton following up with a headshot onto Macha. Oh, Hat standing in the smoke, actually managing to take out on his guard. That's quite impressive stuff. Icon's checking out a grenade, very promising grenade there, but did not land. I believe it might have just landed on the roof, and now Arcane should have a solid control over this B side. Danae is going to take out Hat, so it's going to be a tougher situation here for FX to come back with this one, especially when you have a two-man deficit as well. And it looks like Icons is just going to be sitting in spawn, as well as Anakin hoping to find a peek to make it a little bit more easier. Actually, Icons does connect a shot onto Hatton. Still three more left to find, with a bomb taken away in a pretty fast manner. Icons here are gonna move in, and has just spotted one, so might just go for a quick peek, but the crossfire setup should be there, and actually Icons does manage to get himself into the dark room, and again will go down. Brilliant shot from Icons to shut down Jordan. However, the time is now running out, and Savvy to take him out with a jump shot, 1-1. Arcane going fast on that B bomb side, really that aggression seems to be nice, but FX should be answering now with a couple of grenades towards that APC to stop them from going towards that position fast. Looks like Macha again is going to make his way across, has been shut down by Savvy though. Not sure if his grenade is still there. Hatton's going to follow up with a frag as well to Viagor, and it was actually who was it? Either way, Hatton, yeah. Hatton and Hat. The names sound so similar, but Hat does take out two players now, and all those guys are gonna get shut down on that bomb. So it's all even. Hatton's pulling 1-2 to smoke, misses all the shots. Hat does take him down, 2-on-2 now. Hat there picking up a triple kill, really nice. Really put FX back into the round. Now it's a 2-on-2, it's probably gonna be an afterplant situation here as Danae was actually forced off that bomb plant. Gonna go for it now. And Icons just needs to find Savvy here, but Savvy's sitting in deep in spawn. Danae just spotted a glimpse of Anaxagar. Danae will jump around, does land the shot onto Anakin. So it's down to Icons yet again, 1-on-2.
Nexus eliminated.
Can't be handling that one. Sevi coming in from the back, taking him out. 2-1. And that is Arcane taking the lead now. Let's find Sevi. Gonna be looking for those cross kills. Hasn't been landing any good shots though on the first cross, but did land one before in the second one. Not gonna be going for that now. And we don't see any of the FX players going for that cross this time. Instead, they're gonna go around the back as that bomb is now being planted. It's still a 5-on-5 because the icons are lining up a grenade. Hatton does take out much icons with that grenade, lands it onto Onizagar. Vigor comes with a frag onto Hatton. And where is Vio? Oh, it's just gonna get shut down as soon as it got to him. And now, see FX going in for that push. Sevi does take out Hatton, doing great work with his sniper. Anakin now in trouble as he's being tagged up by the M on the ground. Ooh, Anakin gonna spray a couple of shots towards the top spawn. There is Icons firing off a shot. Sevi here just needs to sit in his position and not die, as his bomb will tick away. There's no way that FX will be able to defuse the bomb. They're nowhere near that bomb site. There we go, Arcane. Jordan and Dane collectively gonna put them out of their misery. And that is another round there for Arcane. Solid job for the attackers at the moment. Anakin does get tagged up. Will he get across though as the nades do come in again? Dane with a perfect timing. Sevi follows up with a frag on Macha. Macha was tagged though, but great performance there, but Icons comes back with a double grenade kill. But it's now all down to Viagor in a 1-on-3. Has just spotted one in the mid guard and not going to be able to land it. Oh, lands it with a Luger. This is such a lucky shot. Oh, Viagor goes absolutely big. Takes out Sevi, now down to a 1-on-1. And picks up the frag into Dani as well. Going to pick up the Thompson for the next round and go for that defuse. And that, ladies and gentlemen, was a 1-on-3 from Viagor coming out of nowhere. 3-2. What a fantastic play by the Dutchman.
Axis win.
Wow. So looking over the scoreboard right now, we do have Macho at 0 frags. He seems to be the one always to cross, but this time he's going to go towards that A side. I doubt he's going to be seeing any sort of action right there. So let's pick it up with Onizuka actually going to get team killed by Hatton. That's really a Karsus curse right there. And Sevi here looking for that frag. Not going to be finding anything. I'm flicking about a little bit too fast, I feel. But Viagor in the dark room should be sitting quite safely. Let's have a bird's eye view of the situation here. So we got Viagor in the dark room. I believe we got Anakin here in the B alley. Couple of players now moving up as Viagor should be careful. Brilliant camera angle. Nope. Viagor just been spotted there. Oh, Hatton unable to close out that kill. Viagor again getting those headshots in. Viagor now running out of ammo though. He's gonna go for that reload and Jordan's gonna hit that reload. Perfect timing there. Gonna jump in that dark room, taking out Viagor. That's going to leave that B-bomb side quite open. Machado is going to get taken out by Dane. Dane is going to go for that bomb plant, surely. Okay, and we'll pick up that round. As it's down to 2-on-3. And Arcane with 3 players on the bomb, they should be able to get a counter frag in if they do lose a player here. Nobody seems to be peeking as of yet for... Arcane boys, and there goes Hat. He's been shut down by Sevi. It's down to Icons. And 1-on-3. This time a little bit of a more difficult situation. He got 3 players on the same side. And now he has been spotted. Dane with the hat shot. 4-2. Jordan coming in with the BM. Dane as well. Why not? Still a 2-round lead here for Arcane. Do maintain it. Sevi does miss the shot on the cross. Gonna go for that second try. There we go. He lands it onto Macha. Smoking now way too late. Theogore does reply with Ash out of his own onto Atten. And it's Danae to move in. Ash just put the two players out there, tagging up all the players from Apex. Theogore again with the dirty headshots, taking out Danae. And that's just Theogore. I mean, I think all of his kills have been pretty much headshots so far. That's just absolutely insane. What does he got though? Could be doing some damage here for his team as he's gone behind enemy lines. Will he be successful in doing enough damage? I mean, at least you could get one kill. Ash just put a one player, so he's gonna sneak in behind him. Is he gonna go for that bash? Looks like he might do so. He's gonna slap him in the ass, and there's Vigor down. As he likes it. Oh, there we go. One of these guys gonna take out Icons as well. Such a sneaky little play from the Frenchman. Anakin now worried. His flank is being exposed. Hat is going to be down on that B side as well. So Arcane just need to realize where FX are. Ooh, looks like Hat was pushing about. Has to shut down Jordan. Now, what is he on that MG? Could he be able to find a glimpse? Hat is actually going to pre-fire that MG position, but Savvy now going to take him out. It's all down to Anakin. As Onizuka was... I think, no, it was actually Savvy already on that A side. Going for a bit of a bomb tickle, and Anakin has yet to rotate. Has just given his position away by running him about like an elephant. Does not land that initial shot. Can't land the second one either. Gonna go for the jump shot. No, Savvy is gonna be behind that wall. Surely Onizuka will be there as soon as Anakin does come close. There we go. We can see definitely Onizuka here with a crossfire set up. As Savvy does show his hat just a little bit. So Anakin now, 1-on-2, gonna go on a jump. Oh, not gonna be finding that shot. Onizuka though from the back takes him out. 5-2. Really brilliant play there from Onizuka coming behind enemy lines. That made all the difference there in that round. Savvy here on the cross. Just dodged that nade, so that's all good. And FX not really fancying to going for that B push there. Instead wanted to go in the flank, and that grenade not getting rid of much of there. So unfortunate for Arcane. Oh, Icon's coming again with that same grenade. Always just landing here. And Anakin now following up with a headshot onto Savvy. And it looks like FX now finding themselves in a good position here. But Arcane now on that B bomb side, they're surely not down. They were definitely down, but not out yet. As long as they will plant that bomb, they just need to be able to lock down the site. And FX now need to use their numbers. And that smoke still up on that BLE is definitely going to work in favor of Arcane. So it pretty much forces FX to go from one side, from that APC side. There's only two entries. One of the entries has been smoked off. Danae is going to be proning down. Oh wow, what a beautiful shot from Danae, just out of nowhere, taking out Mache. And now it's all even Stevens on his gut. On his own, as Danae goes down. He's going to try and make it a 1-on-1. Not going to happen, does take out Icons. 1-on-1 now, but Anakin comes in with a pistol. Takes him out, 5-3, and what a neat round for FX there. 5-3 indeed. And much of this there with a quick magical reconnect.
Explosives diffused. Axis win.
Let's pick up with Savvy once again in the early rounds, in the early couple of seconds. Again, FX doesn't seem to be fancying crossing just yet. That smoke does come out. And again, lots of aggression from that A flank, but Arcane having a couple of grenades lined up for it as Vigor does come down from that grenade. Icons does take out Hatton there with a scope frag. So we're all even, but yet again, Arcane on that B bomb site. However, that smoke kind of failed, so that could still work in the favor of FX. Maybe Hat can go from that prone peak, taking out one player here. That would be terrific if he could do that. As he does make his way forward, Icons has been tagged up, but now head here on the prowl slowly. Let's quick look if there is anyone out here. Looks like there's one in the office. Icons can't seem to be getting rid of that one player, and Dane is going to take out Mache. So it's looking pretty grim here for FX. Hat has yet to make his move, can't really seem to be finding anyone. Does take out one player, it's going to be down to Icons, and not going to be closely towards that bomb site. So it's, surely there's going to be another round for Arcane. As the bomb is ticking away. Oh, what? Okay. Eliminated. But finally, Dane does get rid of Icons. 6-3. Okay, now doing a pretty good job on their attacking side. If they pick up a couple of more rounds, then they're well, fine and dandy. Probably in eight rounds, that would be good. Xavier is going to take out much early doors, but will get returned by Icons. I'm not sure from where, I believe from top spawn house. And now FX boys are making their way in towards B. Does work out. Vigor though gonna get grenaded down. Jordan with the carbine. Gonna get tagged up. That's one player out there and gonna spot his feet. I believe it's gonna be Mache out there. And this is such an awkward situation here for Jordan. He's got 9 bullets as well. Not landing shot. Icons will land it. It was actually Icons out there. Icons now with 2 frags. Hat is gonna finish it off. Onto Hatton. 6-4. Still the advantage for Arcane, but FX do come back with a round, and if they pick up another round, that's a solid half for them. Ooh, and I can just pick up the frag on Hatton early doors, and Savvy grenading down, and I can. Igor here. Was looking to move himself in towards that B bomb site, but I guess he was a little bit too late on the cross. Icons does grenade down on his guy. Oh, Icons with the carbine on the cross takes out Dane through that darkroom window. Now it's down to only 2 players from Arcane, Jordan and Savvy. And I don't know if Jordan is it really paying off for him and still having that carbine. I don't know, like. Jordan here. And Savvy both in the same position. Beautiful headshot from Jordan. Just coming out. And now FX with 2 players from Bialy coming in. Savvy gonna hear those 2 players. Gonna switch to his M1 Grand. Will take out Mache. Hat does come around with the shotgun. Oh, beautiful play there from Hat. Takes out 2 players. And will go for that bomb defuse. 6-5. FX, beautiful retake there. Did take him a little while.
Explosives defused.
But it's all good.
Axis win.
Mache. I believe he's yet to get a frag as well. But maybe he will do soon now. He got himself across, so that's all good. Head dust grenade down on his guy. Oh, Mache. So unfortunate that Savvy was there with his scope, he had no chance. But Arcane not on the bomb yet, so Anakin now gonna be sitting in Darkroom, so it's looking good here for FX. Might just be an equal scoreline going into that second half, which is super good here for the FX side. Vigor here picking up yet another frag for FX. As Arcane with 3 players around that APC area, and I wonder if there's still a grenade. Vigor still has a grenade, Icon still has a grenade. So still 2 more grenades on FX. And even though, even if Anakin will go down, it doesn't matter. I mean, FX will just grenade the shit out of that B bomb side when Arcane do decide to plant it. But they still have got to get rid of Anakin in that darkroom. Doing all sorts of naughty stuff. Will get taken out by Jordan, so that grenade coming in, actually tagging up Hatton, but a wall does save him, but Icons comes in with the grenade. He has so many grenade kills, that man. I believe he had 6 grenade kills this half. At least. So 2-on-2, it's all still possible here for Arcane to come on top in this first half. Savvy there, Takes out Hat. So all down to Viagor. Has done a clutch before, but now it's a little bit of a different situation against Sevi. And Jordan will be together and having a bit of a buddy system. Sevi holding that BLE. Oh, he got prone blocked! That was the golden opportunity for Viagor to take out Jordan, but Jordan flicks around, takes him out. 7-2-5. But is it gonna be enough to claim that first map for Arcane? I doubt it. And Sevi is doing great for himself. He's sitting on 20 frags, so that's so good. I hope Macho will do better for FX on this half. I mean, it's the definition of being unlucky, I guess. So, picking up with a man himself, Icons. I've seen him go crazy on this map, so let's see if he can do it again. Looks like Arcane are not actually just fancying to cross there. Icons actually just nearly killing his own team teammate there, but Anakin has been shut down early on. FX should be getting towards that B bomb site without any sort of problems here. Viagor is still holding that BLE. And he should be making the call, but I guess FX is just slowing down a little bit, making sure all those nades are gone. Viagor is gonna just go for that fake. And if FX in fact can just successfully hold that the rotation from A, from the flank, then he should be able to pick up the round. As this bomb is now be planted, Hat does take out Sevi there, and it's gonna be a 4-on-4 Arcane. You know, it's still an even in terms of players, but you always need an additional player to actually claim back that B side. And there's Macho finally picking himself up the first frag of the game. And Hatton does return the favor, takes out Hat. Macho here facing two players coming from that APC. They just tag up one. It was on his guy out there. Grenade comes in, and there's Macho down. Okay, wow, oh, this guy just came around the corner, and there's Viagor with a pump gun. There we go, Viagor finds himself another frag, should be doing that easily as he does. Icons here, going for the pistol, not gonna win it though against the Luger. One on one, but actually the time has already run down. 7-2-6, and there's FX picking up that first round on the second half. Icons going a bit of a forward peek here, expecting the opposing scope to pick him down, but on the looks of it, nobody crossing. Lots of emphasis being put on the middle area here for Arcane. Jordan actually holding the cross for Runizuka. Runizuka, can't land it. A little bit too far range, does land on the Viagor, picks up Hat as well. Runizuka here. Gonna run out of bullets as Anakin picks himself the double onto Jordan and Onizuka. Tanito does take out Onizuka with that Anaxagar, sorry, with a grenade frag. So 3-on-3 as Sevi does down Icons. It's in here. Let's just hit a player around A, and it was gonna be Macho. And now 8-6, 1-1 in the first in the second half. As Sevi is still doing great. 21-6. They just need to take out Sevi, because considering he's only got 6 deaths, and that's the 6 rounds that FX have picked up. Icons did just spot a player again. Again, Jordan and Onizuka going for that mid aggression, and Icons gotta get shut down by Sevi here. And Sevi proving his point to be a good scope, and stacking up well against Icons. Jordan here does take out Anakin, so it's a 3-on-5. It's a pretty tough situation here for FX to hold that bomb side. especially with three pretty much stacked up on there. Not a lot of room for falling back or retreating to the Maginot line, if you like to say so. What is he got? Going for a grenade. No one is there though, so good positioning from FX. Expecting still a grenade that was picked up. Machido does go down. Vigor here is gonna have to face a lot of Germans. Does pick up two kills. Hatwell down one as well. And there's Vigor picking us up the triple. And the clock is running down. And that is great play yet again from Vigor. That is a George Foreman as Vigor picks up the round for FX. Objective destroyed. Icons again on the cross, but again it doesn't seem like Arcane fancy to cross towards that B side. Macho gonna get taken out by Hatton, having a bit of the angle advantage. Anakin does return the favor here. We can see Onis got pushed up, taken out. Vigor does hear another player out there, gotta go with a bit of a jump shot to see where he is. And looks like Onis guy's just gonna fall back towards that bomb site, and that is the wise thing to do here. Hatto was already out there. And perhaps that's a little bit poor play from Arcane, not knowing that Hat was going to be out there. So now 3-on-3. Macho again, going to go for the reconnect. See if he can pull some new magic out of the Hat. Hat's going to plant that bomb. Icons holding that BLE, so should be doing all fine. And Arcane just going to let them plant the bomb and gonna try and lock them in that side. Still, I believe there was Anakin in spawn. He's gonna be causing some problems here for Arcane to make their rotation. Has been tagged up. Anakin just needs to run away. Does successfully do so, and it's gonna be Jordan out there facing Icons. Surely Anakin will also be there. Gonna get tagged up as well. Oh, Jordan coming in with the repeat. Does take out Icons 2-on-2. It's a bit of a messy round. Jordan lands a beautiful headshot onto Hat. It is now a 1-on-2 situation here for Anakin. Will land attack, but not a frag. That's heavy. Anakin needs to rotate. Picks up the frag and December. Beautiful shot by Anakin. He just needs to take out Jordan. Jordan actually going to take him out. And that is such a brilliant play from Jordan to take out three players, picking up the round for Arcane. 9-2-7 coming in with the bomb defuse, just in a nick of time. I believe there was only 1 second left. Wow. Anakin's facing Savvy on the cross. Still, he's gonna hold his ground. Not being deterred by Savvy's presence out on the B tank. And actually, notably, Icons hasn't been picking up a kill yet since his defensive side. There's Macha picking up a kill, finally! As he downs Hatton. So Macha out there on that A side. With FX going down with three players, they might be able to surprise Arcane though, but Savvy is going to be out there all too ready and waiting for him. Vigor is going to peek around and decides to kind of back off here. He doesn't have a range element. Has seen that MP44. He's got a grenade there as well, so should be able to grenade down Savvy potentially. Doesn't land it though. Icons here. Is it on his guy here? Going aggressive again. Jordan will go down. That's Macha picking up himself the second kill. I believe that's already more than he had in the entire game. At least after his reconnect. Savvy on the B tank. Kinda losing the overview. Okay, two players from FX on A. Icons in spawn. Gotta get shut down by Onizuka. They were kinda playing a cat and mouse game. But you know, gotta plant the bomb. Onizuka was holding that angle, making sure nobody's gonna go towards that spawn. Savvy, I'm kinda worried that there's gonna be some form of presence out there on that mid area. Dana looking to pick around. Vigor takes out Savvy. Dana will die too much. All down to Onizuka. And it's gonna be a pretty tough one because you can see Vigor is just gonna be running away. Machida is gonna keep his distance as well from the shotgun of Onizuka. Will move in. Where is Vigor? Doesn't even matter. Machida will take him out. That is great play from the two Dutchies. 9-8. Machida picking up 4 kills that round. See what these nades are going to be landing. And nobody already crossing. 2 plays from Arcane. Make that 3 actually going towards that mid side. Anakin was ready for Dane though. The welcoming committee. The bomb has been tickled. Icons picking up a frag. Will get plundered as well. Savvy's going to grenade down Mache. Icons. I believe his gun jammed there. So there's one on the cross. And now 3-on-4 is going to be a difficult situation for Arcane to retake that side. As Anakin is going to be out there on that ABC area. Hatton coming in the back from the burning tank. Anakin will take out on his guy. Hat is going to follow up with a frag onto Savvy. And it's all left up to Hatton. Not going to be happening as Vigor will take him out. Even Stevens 9-9. Looking good here for Epix. See, what's on his guy up to this round? Spotting 2 grenades, does touch it nicely. And he's actually picked up the MP44, so I'm kind of wondering who's shotgunning now. On his guy going on top of that wall to see if there's anyone out there. Did just spot a glimpse, but surely Icons will probably be there anytime soon just to pick him out. He's watching towards that A side and should be hearing a player to his left right now. There's also Macha probably out there. There we go, Macha is going to take him out. And Danny has also been shut down early in the early rounds, in the early seconds of the round. So that is not good for Arcane here with only 3 players left alive to retake a bombsite. Jordan though does pick up a beautiful shot onto Anakin. Sammy's going to even the odds now onto Macha. As FX now still face 3 angry Arcane players. Jordan being tanked up. Still with the rifle in hand. Could be a dangerous player. What's gonna go for the bash, but Icons with MP44 will come on top. That's gonna down Hatton. Icons has been shut down. It's gonna be down to Savvy, but the clock's ticking away. It's not gonna be happening, even though if all the players were down, Savvy couldn't even make it towards that bomb. So that's gonna be the round for FX. Nice shot there from Sevito, but doesn't matter. 10-9. Objective destroyed. Savvy there nearly on 30 frags. And Icons gotta get shut down by Savvy as well. That man seems to be really on fire in this game. But Arcane can't really solely rely on Savvy here. See if Machida is going to be able to do something here. He's out there on A long, so might be able to get a peek in. I did see, was it Danny out there with the shotgun? So this could be a weird approach here. Oh, did Anakin just spot him out there? Vigor coming in now. They are going to beat up. And oh, what a timing there from Danny. That's just been shut down by Vigor. And that is so unfortunate. As he pretty much was forced to watch two angles. Now Anakin is going to be watching the Darko. Machida is going to take out Jordan. And this is looking like a solid A push here from FX with 2 players on A from Arcane. Doesn't look very likely that Savvy is going to be stopped on his own, but maybe he can. As that bomb is going to get planted here for FX. And it looks like it might just be in a favorable position. I can't really see it from his perspective, so let's have a quick look. It is planted for that top spawn now, so is Icon still out there? That would be good. Oh no, actually Icon's got set down. But Hat is still out there, just took out Hatton. But Savvy does reply with the MG onto Hat. Nearly falling to his death there, and now 2-on-3. Pretty tough here for Arcane, as now It's all down to Savvy. Gonna happen here. Vigor, you're gonna take him out. 11-9. Fix. Now well in the lead by 2 rounds. Especially on that favorable side now. I can only expect that they will pick up that first map here on Burgundy. As there's only a couple of more rounds to go. Let's see. Looks like these Germans do try to make themselves across. Machido is going to be holding that BLE, so there's no way that Arcane are going to make themselves get themselves towards that darkroom easily. Machido is going to go for that fake. Maybe letting Arcane think they are going to blunt that bomb. Tornado comes from the back, takes out Icons. It is a 4-4 after blunt again. It's a tough situation here for Arcane, as that bomb will be ticking down. And again, on this map, there's only two ways to come from to defuse that bomb. And it would be so much interesting if the garage, for example, was open, or this building. Actually, I don't know. Just wanted to put it out there. But Fiagor does pick up the frag. The Sevi is now down to 2 players. Rock can make that just one. It's only on to Onizuka. Does pick up the first frag. Switches to his gun at the wrong time. And that will take him out now. 12-9. It's going to be 3 map points for FX to close out the map here on Burgundy. And let's pick it up with Sevi here if we can find him in time. See if he's going to be able to pick up himself with the first. To do that 30 kill, a magical 30 bomb. And Arcane now got themselves a lot of work to do here. Still 3 more rounds to pick up to get themselves to an overtime. And of course, it's not going to be easy on this defensive side. However, they do manage to get themselves across with 2 players. It's Jordan out there. Machido lining up a grenade towards that BLE. No one there though. And we got one at the hay belt. It's going to be Hatton. Jordan out there. So the 2 Brits on that B side, however, 4 players from FX stacking up on that APC area. A 1 nade from Arcane could do a lot of damage. And Icon's gonna line up a grenade here, forcing Hatton from his position. Will take him out with the scope, so that grenade wasn't even needed. Machido is gonna follow up with the frag of the Jordan. This is a very textbook style attack from FX. Still no smoke there, probably already faded away actually. And Icon's finding himself another frag for FX as he downs Onizuka. And it is down to Sevi and Danny. At least Sevi should be picking up that 30 bomb as Danny now goes down. So 1-on-4. There's the 30 bomb. Connects a shot onto Vigor. 3 more plays to find. Did spot one out there on the mid street. Is it going to be possible though with 45 seconds left on the clock? Actually, make that just 30. Actually, need 10 seconds to fuse the bomb. And Savvy comes around, will get shut down by Macha. 13-9, quite convincing score. It was 6-6 in the first half. FX naturally should be was able to close it out on their attacking side. Second map is going to be Donville, and again it's going to be the defensive side this time to be the most favorable side to watch. However, it could be that